Guys with nasty ass fish breath. Too. Oh my
God. What?
There's this
Isn't
video.
Isn't that the thing they do? They just like get as musty as possible before a fight, right?
Exactly.
And then
yes.
You just,
yes.
Exactly.
Some girls don't shave their armpits.
Oh, that's bad. I swear, some girls
will not shave their armpits.
That's a good idea,
so, like,
though.
Somebody was like, "Hey, no headlocks, no headlocks." Like, what are you talking
You're
about?
You're like tough shit.
DQ headlock.
Let go of her armpit hair.
There's a YouTube video of this guy, this grappling match, and one of the guys actually like leg locks the guy and farts, and he throws up and taps out.
All right, guys. Yeah, yeah. We're going to go ahead and kick off the cameras. Hang tight.
Hello.
You're on the Virtual Entertainment Programming Network, TVEPN.com. EPN Studios, The Slam Show. And now, your host, Slam.
What's up, everyone, to Hello. Another edition of The Slam Show for June 30th, 2014. I am the mad scientist wannabe tonight here on this episode of The Slam Show because, as you can tell, we got some interesting happenings stored for this program, and you do not want to miss this at all. Tell your friends, tweet, Instagram, tell them to go on tonight at this moment because we are going deep into the lab to create some incredible beverages that you've never ever seen before. So I can't wait to get this whole program kickstarted. But before I do, I'd like to go ahead and have my co-hosting staff introduce themselves. Let's start with Mr. Time.
Wow, Joe Coors from Joe Time Entertainment. Hello.
Cindy here.
And Shani Donnelly.
And our special guest, females first.
AP, what's up?
Yo, Paul Vogt here from How You Been.
There you go. I like how you did that. Yo, you try to get that street
how
angle.
You been?
I was about to introduce my co-host.
Yes, yes. Have her go in the mic real quick.
Hi, I'm Leah.
So, welcome everyone. I really am so excited, so stoked because we got a lot of good stuff going. And also props out to Lady Sage. She is still out doing family business over
What's
in Colorado.
Woo!
She'll be back.
Miss you, girl. Yep.
Oh, you know it's legal over there.
That's right. The Amsterdam feel.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Yes, yes. So she'll be back next week to resume her seat on the show. So everyone hang tight. We're going to make a great show regardless because we got so much to get into. But before all that, we like to always review our past show. And last week, we had Aaron Miles, Major League Baseball legend. I'm going to say legend because he's a cool-ass motherfucker. From born and raised here in Pittsburgh, Antioch area, as well as Tyler Burke, the Guinness World Record for catching the most arrows blindfolded within, was it 1 minute or 2 minutes?
I think it was two, right?
2 minutes, yeah. So I'll give you my insights. Shani, Cindy, you were here last week, so I'll have you give an opportunity and so forth on your angle. But boy, as far as Aaron, cool guy. Fun personality. I really enjoyed just his stories. It was just really compelling to know that he worked his butt off to get where he got as far as being able to stay in the major leagues for all these seasons, nearly freaking 10 years, a decade being in the major leagues, making major league money.
That's a long time.
So much props to Aaron, and I'm glad that he's moving forward with coaching as well as doing stuff for the community. That was really
nice.
Good.
Really cool.
And Tyler, he was more laid back, wouldn't you say? And he was just kind of like, oh, well, hey, give me the other Q&A, the more rated X versions, because that's what we'll give you guys. But it's 10 questions, and we have tame ones, and then we have the real adult ones. So we gave him a real tame one.
Uh-oh.
And he was like, is this what it is? I'm like, yeah, because we're trying to protect your reputation, but all right. Then we snuck in that last one where it was rated X, and he was
he didn't mind it at all.
It was like he wasn't really into it. So overall, Tyler, thank you. Next time, you're going to get the rated X. So, Cindy, Shaney, let's go with you, Shaney. How was our guest last week?
I thought Aaron was awesome. A very humble guy, real, easy to talk to, super funny. And I agree with you, Sam, of him doing everything with the community, getting the kids out there, and then also his team now. What is it, the Pittsburgh Medals?
Yes. Medals. Yeah. Not like Army medals, but metal. Like, I'm meddling in your business.
The medals.
Yeah.
T-T-L-E.
And he also, so he coaches it, and he gets to play on it. So it's kind of cool.
Yeah.
And then Tyler, he was really funny. He does everything, it sounds like.
Yeah.
But he says he has no time for anything. So, I don't know. He was a cool guy.
Yeah, he wants to make short films. He wants to do other world record feats. So much props to Tyler.
But he passed up world... That talent show? What was that one?
Yeah.
Oh, America's Got Talent.
Yeah. So he beats to his own drum.
Yeah.
Let's agree on that. Cindy.
It was actually really interesting to finally meet Aaron because I'd heard so much about him through other sources. And he was just not what I expected at all. In a good way.
That's what I was going to say.
Yeah, in a really good way. He has been through the ringer and back, and it's really remarkable to see, you know, where he's at now and what he's doing, and it was really cool to talk to him. And as for Tyler, I thought it was really cool that he uses all old school equipment he was talking about. I was like, you know, what are you working with? What kind of archery do you do? Do you have like a compound? I'm all expecting like Walking Dead, you know, crossbow status, and he's like, no, it's just, you know, and it looked like it was something that he made or crafted. It was
exactly
really cool.
It wasn't one of those like Avengers Hawkeye looking mechanical things. It was like he basically built it from scratch.
It's huge.
Yeah,
it was like as tall as us. So.
Mm-hmm.
I was very impressed.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't hit too many things bringing that thing in here. But, yeah, like, bam, bam, bam. So, but, yeah, overall, on that program and other programs, if you missed it, just go to slamshow.com or slamshow.tv for all the replays. So, as we always elaborate, our past weekend haps, and I want to go straight to Mr. Joe time, since you weren't here last week. What's been going on? I see that you are a very busy man.
I've been busy. I've been up and down the coast of California, from Santa Cruz, Sacramento, San Francisco, you know, just doing stand-up comedy and, you know, just kind of getting myself out there more than ever because, like I said, I just got signed with a talent agency and I want to prep myself and be more exposed to, you know, getting out there and really pursuing my craft and really refining myself and taking myself to the next level so that when I do get those auditions, when I do get those gigs, I'll be able to deliver even, you know, more than what they expect from me.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yay.
Wait, I think we did give you applause the last time you were here, right?
We can give him another one.
Yeah. Gotta do the reverse applause.
I know.
So, cool. Right on.
Thank you.
And you're going to be on for quite a long stretch here on the Slam Show.
Yeah,
I'm ready
and excited.
And just tell everyone how they could follow you on Instagram and all that stuff.
Yeah, you can catch me at Joe Time. It's Joe_Time at Instagram, on Instagram. And then if you go to my little profile thing, it'll say my Facebook, which is facebook.com/JoeTimeComedy. And then I'll definitely be having a website up soon. We already got the name. The domain is available, so we're really about to lock it in very soon. So I'm not going to say it. Try to cash me up so you can sell it to me. Never.
That's right.
But yeah, I got that under wraps, so it's going to be fun.
Awesome. Cool. Cindy, how was your weekend?
It been okay. It was mostly work and family. I had a really shitty fishing trip. I don't know if y'all saw that on Facebook. But, you know, hot gravel, dried up lake, didn't catch anything. You know?
Sounds like the apocalypse.
Sunburn. Yeah, it kind of was.
Walking Dead shit.
It kind of was, yeah.
But you had to have a few drinks, right? I mean, to get through the day.
No, I went by myself, so I didn't take any alcohol. I'd, you know, drive home an hour, that would be stupid. So I didn't bring any booze with me, but... Yeah,
wow, that really is a bad day.
Wait, right?
Paul's like, why did you call me? I'd be there.
It's a Reka.
But the thing is, like, I put an APB out on Facebook, like, hey, who wants to go to the lake and work on your tan and go fishing? And like, nobody did. And I was like, all right, I'll go by myself then. And it was pretty disappointing.
Maybe they already knew that it was dried up.
I know, right? They could have said, you know, Cindy, I don't recommend that place.
Exactly.
You know,
they wanted you to suffer.
Right? Dicks. All right.
They went on Google Earth, and they saw the dried up lake and said, oh, no problem.
Yeah. Right?
Oh, well. That's fine. But you made the most out of it, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's all that counts.
I got some aloe at CVS on the way home.
They got aloe at the place.
No. That was when I got back to town.
Yeah, I was like, wait a second. They have a shop there? Interesting. Right on.
We're going to call you for fishing next time.
All right, good.
My weekend was pretty interesting. Normally, I don't take my training clients on the weekend, and I actually had clients on Saturday and Sunday, which was fun, and I actually got to work out with one of my clients. We kind of challenged each other. So that was exciting to see that she can kind of keep up now. And then went to one of my buddy's birthday parties and hung out with some friends on Sunday. Yeah, it was pretty chill.
Right on, right on. Cool. AP, what'd you do?
I worked.
Don't tell me.
I just worked. Well, I made drinks and got everyone else drunk.
There you go. Yes, she is a bartender.
Nice.
Yeah.
Another party I missed.
Do you drink Fernet? Oh, yes. All right.
She's all,
Of course I do.
All right. She's a real bartender.
This other bar in Antioch I bartend at is called I Carumba. Like, we have regulars, and they could buy us drinks.
Nice.
And we drink with them, and we just put it on their tab. So,
all right.
And they still tip us on it. So they're paying us to drink with them, which is pretty amazing.
Can't complain.
I've never done that.
I haven't. It's amazing. I'll call you next time.
Absolutely.
You could bring your
I'll be a virgin. I'll do my first time. Nope.
Paul, how was your weekend?
Oh, great weekend. It was actually Leah's birthday.
Happy birthday.
Oh, happy belated.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
So we celebrated in style. We went out ocean fishing under the Golden Gate, and we caught, like, you wouldn't believe, including, like, I should pull up my phone. I mean, like, a monster. Yeah, ling caught. I mean, about 3.5 feet.
Any pictures or anything?
I do.
Okay, well, bring it up later.
We'll pull up later on, but... after fishing, we went to a foam party out in San Francisco. So,
okay.
So we put her in the foam pit, and she danced her...
life away.
Her life away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You sign papers for that?
I should have. She came away with, like, some monster bruises.
I knew you looked familiar.
So then we had a couple of events, though, and you know, I had two shows this weekend, so...
Right.
We do lots of donations around town and in our local community, so we used actually one of our products for tonight that we donated to some schools.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah.
That's an awesome deal. And pretty... when you're doing... just to kind of jump into some of the details of the whole how you being... product, is it a weekend thing mainly, or is it pretty much any day of the week?
No, so weekends we do tons of festivals. We're going to be at Wonderlust in Colorado this weekend. We're going to be at the South Park Music Festival this weekend. So the weekends we do events, and then during the week we cater.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's cool. Right on. Well, as far as my weekend, it was basically... few events. Shaney and I were over at Ricky's birthday party. We were hanging out, and that was kind of cool, be able to share that moment with my protege as far as in the music business, seeing him turn 50. Just kidding. We love you, Ricky.
He's going to kill you.
Exactly.
He's 29 still. What are you talking about?
Yeah. 29.
Anniversary of 21.
Yeah. Again. No. But afterwards, we headed out. Well, actually, I had to work over at Lift Lounge and do my usual resident DJ stuff over there. And if you haven't been there, please check it out. It's always popping. Summertime, packed. Got to get there early before 10 o'clock or else your ass out in that long line. And that's pretty much it. Everything's just going in cruise control. So let's go ahead and move into the commercial break. And after that, no topics. We're going to go right into the interview segments, just like we did last week, because we got so much to talk about.
We do.
It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, guys, stay tuned here on The Slam Show. We'll be right back.
Cash now, call 1-800-CAR-TITLE to borrow $2,500 to $50,000 against the value of your vehicle. 1-800-CAR-TITLE has been offering the lowest rates and monthly payments for over 10 years. Mention promo code FREEWAY to receive free gas with your loan. 1-800-227-8485. 1-800-CAR-TITLE, a proud supporter of the Freeway Series.
1-800-CAR-TITLE, fast cash and low payments every day.
It's hurricane and wildfire season again. Why do thousands of people sit in these reoccurring problem areas year after year, betting their lives that the disaster won't get them? Hundreds of you helped eFoods Direct ship 50,000 donated meals to the Oklahoma victims. The problem is we can't help everybody. If every one of us who can will take care of ourselves, we can all pitch in to take care of those who really can't. The new just-in-case pack from eFoods Direct is the big brother to the 7-day emergency pack designed for Oklahoma disaster donations. It contains a 2-month supply for one person, or a 1-month supply for two adults, or a 2-week supply for a family of four. The $320 price is $50 less than retail. Call 800-409-5633 on the web eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Order two or more, get 10% off, free shipping applies. Call 800-409-5633 on the web eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
Protecting your home with a security system is a must. But when it comes to protecting your family, your home, and belongings, there's no need to sign a long-term contract. Listen, there is some real scum in the alarm business cashing in by locking you into long, punishing contracts. Not with Simply Safe Home Security. They're the good guys. You can trust Simply Safe to protect your family. Simply Safe was created by a Harvard Business School engineer, and it's revolutionary. You'll get 24-hour protection for just $14.99 a month. There are no hidden fees and no contracts. You'll save thousands. Plus, you're protected by their 100% money-back guarantee. Protect yourself against home invasions and break-ins. Order your Simply Safe system now and receive a wireless keychain remote, a $25 gift, free. So don't waste your time dealing with scum. Visit GetSimplySafe.com. GetSimplySafe.com. GetSimplySafe.com.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gates, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Taking a family of five to the amusement park can cost a small fortune.
Oh, yeah. So to save some money, we thought, hey, let's bring the amusement park to us. Yeah. Go ahead.
All right. Step right up. Step right up, young man. Are you ready to ride the Wacky Waterfall?
That's just the bathtub with the shower head running.
Nope, it's the Wacky Waterfall.
It's the shower, Dad.
Waterfall.
Wacky.
There's an easier way to save. To get a free rate quote, go to geico.com. Then buy online, over the phone, or at your local Geico office.
You know the U.S. dollar is devaluing. You can see it happening every day. You know a new currency will take over at some point. Wouldn't you like to be in on the ground floor? Bitcoins. They're a decentralized, anonymous internet currency. They're free to use, free to accept, and free from inflation forever. You can use them anywhere in the world, and their value seems only to be increasing. Find out more at weusecoins.org. Don't be kicking yourself in the pants in a month. Your dollars are going down. Bitcoins are going up. WeUseCoins.org.
Snoring. It's not just something to laugh about. Snoring could be a symptom of sleep apnea, a serious condition where breathing stops during sleep. And if left untreated, can lead to daytime drowsiness while driving, high blood pressure, acid reflux, heart attack, and stroke. Plus, the family issues of the snoring keeping others up all night. The first step in treatment is a sleep study. Through homeapneatest.com, it can now be done in your own home in the comfort of your own bed through the direction of a board-certified sleep medicine physician in your area. The test simply monitors your breathing while you sleep. For more information about sleep apnea, go to homeapneatest.com or call 1-877-54-APNEA, 1-877-542-7632.
If you're suffering from chronic pain, migraine headaches, or any other health issues, it might be your back telling you it's time for an adjustment. Come check out the new Health Chiropractic Center in Concord. We restore the curvatures of the spine to bring you back to good health and wellness. Our specialists will provide a full examination and x-rays for free. Just mention the Slam Show. Call now for an appointment at 925-759-9722 or online at thenewhealthcc.com. In order to transform your health, you have to try something new. The New Health Chiropractic Center.
Yes, welcome back, everyone, to the Slam Show. And as I promised, we are doing an exclusive interview program tonight. And it begins with this young lady. She hails from the hometown city of Pittsburgh, homegrown.
Homegrown.
Yes.
She is an up-and-coming rapper, recording artist. Let's have a big round of applause for AP. And I wasn't going to take any chances with your last name at all because it's sort of a pronunciation tongue twister. Who wants to try it? See?
Is it Tangatow? Tangatow?
Yep.
Okay.
Tangatow.
All right.
Nice.
Get crazy now.
AP, yes. Thank you for being able to make it on the program.
I'm super excited to be here.
You were very excited when I hit you up and I said, hey, I like what you got going here. You're from Pittsburgh. You're doing things. You got a nice website. Your social media is up to speed. Let's get you on the program.
Super excited to be here. I'm super excited. I was driving here and I was sitting in my car oh my gosh.
You're having an orgasm and shit, huh?
Uh-oh.
I was just sitting there oh my gosh. I don't know what to do.
Awesome.
Sister was you can start by getting out. And I was okay, let's go.
Well, let's begin. How did you get influenced with the whole music thing?
Well, growing up, we've always, my dad's side of the family, they have a music background, and my dad's actually Tongan and German, so they grew up in doing music, and we grew up as a band, kind of the little, Selena, have you seen the movie?
Yes.
So we were
Yeah.
And I hated, my dad had me play bass, and I hated it.
Oh, I thought you were Selena.
I wanted to play the drums.
AP.
No, my older sister, she was the Selena. That whore.
Oh.
No, she was the Selena.
Family feud.
But we all grew up singing, playing a musical instrument, and eventually I got into choir in school and stuff like that. And then I was always hanging around my cousins, and they're doing their rap thing, and I was like, man, I bet I could do that.
Mm-hmm.
And then one day we just started kind of freestyling and stuff, and then I kind of came in and they're like, whoa. Hey, you should start doing that. And I was like, yeah, maybe I will. This is pretty fun.
And how
and that's how I got into it.
How old were you?
I was 15.
Okay.
It was we were just joking around at the time. I started off singing.
Gotcha.
And then eventually got into rapping. And I rap more than I sing,
mm-hmm.
which is kind of crazy.
Hey, it's what you're comfortable with.
Yeah.
That's dope. So when you're going into the music, creating it and so forth, what are things you're trying to do to stand out? Because the music industry is pretty saturated, especially in the local scene. Tell me about things that you're trying to do that's unique.
I like, when I'm creating music, I like to, everyone interprets a beat differently. If I get a beat, this is how I feel this is how I feel I should write according to what I feel to this beat. Everyone interprets a beat differently. So when I do hear a beat, it's like, I don't want to talk, like, I hear local artists and all they're talking about is bitches and hoes and I get money. And I don't want to talk about that. You know, I want to come differently.
Why not?
Like, said, I mean, I can. Then I just, you know, sound like, bitch, get money, bitch, fucks hoes. You know, like, it just be, you know, it just sound like everything else. I want to come out fresh. I want to, like, say things, like, I could say what they're saying, but I could say it in a different way. You
yeah.
know, there's, I could put a spin on it or, you know, just like little metaphors here and there, like make it a little more creative, like make it fun.
True.
You know,
true.
Make it catchy, something they'd be like, oh my gosh, it'll stick. And when it sticks, it's like, then they'll come back and they'll be like, what's that one song, you know? And they'll look it up. So I try to come out with something catchy, some feel good stuff too, like something you just vibe to.
That's dope. Like
positive stuff. Not just bitches and
hoes.
Fuck you.
Hoes and clothes. Hey, whatever floats your boat. That's for sure. Now, you being Pacific Islander, big family. It's just everyone's like always looking out for each other. Do they have any influence on the type of music or they're just like hands off and let you be?
Somewhat. My little brothers, my brothers and sisters, they will not listen to it if I'm talking about I'm the baddest bitch. I'm this, you know, they don't, bad words. No. So like, I try to tune it down just a little bit mm-hmm. or sometimes like whoever I'm working with, I'll tell them, can you just scratch this, you know, make it PG-13, scratch these bad words out, or I'll just take him out and I'll, instead of putting like bitch, I'll put like chick or girl mm-hmm. or whatever. I'll find a different word.
So right. I'll right.
Definitely tune it down a notch for them.
Gotcha.
Cause they like the reggae and you know, all that stuff. And
yeah.
I don't really listen to that. So
really?
A little bit.
That's like very dedicated to the Islander sound.
Yes.
Yeah, so you gotta enjoy and embrace that and incorporate it somehow.
Oh yeah, absolutely. But it's just the music I want to do. It's hard for me to rap on a reggae beat.
Really?
Yes.
I thought it beats a beat, so it's like just adapt to it, right?
Especially if they're talking about like one love, you know, this. And to me, it's like, okay, like what do I say? Me and my people. I don't know.
Now, do you exclusively write your own music as far as the lyrics and stuff?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
Cool. That's, you got to have creative control.
Yeah.
And you got to be able to know the material that you're writing, because there's like a lot of people out there in the industry that what they call ghostwrite. Having other people do their stuff and people perform it. So much props on that to be able to hold that down. What female rapper right now kind of like you have a similar sound with? Because I heard the track. I heard the dance floor track and this new one that you sent me, which we're going to play after our segment called Copycat. And you have a little Nicki Minaj going. Is that?
I like Nicki.
Okay.
I'm a Nicki fan.
Did you see the BET Awards
no.
on Sunday? She represented. She won Hip Hop Artist of the Year.
Oh, right on.
Yeah,
she got Hip Hop Artist of the Year.
Yeah, again.
Again.
Yeah.
Fifth in a row.
Mm-hmm. All right, Cindy, give you props.
The booty.
You're on it. No, is it the booty?
It's the power of the booty.
Nah, it's album sales. Album sales.
It's not injections?
It probably isn't. It could be fat transfer. It could be real fat.
That's right.
Right? They talked about this with Coco, right? They were talking about.
Yeah, take it from the front and put it in the back. Now, would you consider that?
Yeah, really?
No.
No type of surgery at all?
I'd rather just work out and keep myself fit and
as
natural.
As is?
Yeah, as is.
Okay.
I think that'd be too crazy
all
for
right.
me.
You're saying that now. But once the dollars start rolling in, you'll be like, I want to look like Nicki Minaj.
Nobody
no,
wants
I don't
to look
think
like
so.
Nicki Minaj. No, let's be real.
I don't think so.
Nobody wants to look like that.
Nicki don't even like to look. I'm just kidding.
Well, that's awesome. Well, enough of me asking the questions. I'll have my co-hosting staff go ahead and jump in. We'll start with Joe, work our way down.
How long? Oh, yeah. No, that's awesome, though. I was like, AP and Los Dinos.
No!
biggest question is, other than rapping and singing, are there any other things that you bring to the table? I know that you do a little bit of acting. Tell us a little bit about that. Like, how'd you get into that?
I've always loved acting ever since I was little. I grew up taking acting classes, took acting at Pittsburgh High, eventually went off to some agencies and did acting there. But with acting, it's like you have to be really consistent, and I kind of just fell off. I'm trying to come back and, you know, brushing up on my acting skills and stuff. But it's not like, oh, I'm dying, like super dramatic, you know?
Yeah.
Like I just need to get back in it, but I've been so focused on my music that it's like I can't do it all because I'm working all the time too. So it's like, dang, I'm going to a studio or should I go to this audition? And to me right now, I'm very focused on getting my music out there. But hopefully when my schedule clears up, I want to eventually start getting into acting and getting back in there.
Don't they cross? I mean, if you're a performer on stage, doesn't acting just automatically... I mean, especially when you're doing rap, hip hop, and there's just so much facial expression, so much body expression.
Mm-hmm. What kind of role would you like to have?
I like crazy, like
you want to be the villain,
dramatic villains. I love kick ass girls, like yes, stuff I'd want to do my own stunts. Like
gotcha,
that'd be so dope.
Awesome,
there you go. Awesome. A strong woman character. They got that one movie with Lucy coming out with Scarlett Johansson. That's gonna be awesome.
Yeah. Oh yeah,
I love Scarlett.
She's
Black Widow.
Scarlett Johansson.
Who doesn't like Scarlett?
This, yo, I'm single. You know, I mean, I'm on the rise. Essentially, that means I'm broke. But I mean,
that's cool. So villain roles for you for sure.
Yes.
You don't want to be like the wussy hero type of thing.
Yeah.
But what's wussy about a hero? They're not the hero if they're a wuss, right?
Oh, yeah. True.
You caught that. Thank you, Cindy.
The victim.
Thank you.
Yeah, they're the victim. You don't want
to be a victim. Cool,
cool. Let's see. If you get to travel with your music, like, what music scene do you really want to break into? Because, I mean, it's really easy for us to get in the, like, Bay Area bubble. But, I mean, there's L.A., there's Chicago, there's Detroit, there's Houston. There's so many cool cities of their own, like, hip-hop sound. Like, which one do you want to, like, break into?
What city?
Or? Yeah.
I don't know. I've been going through this like crazy thing. Like, I really do love rap. I love doing like hip hop and R&B, but I love singing in Spanish. Like, so for me to like be able to have a different crowd, like that would be so amazing. Like, I can't
Miami
speak Spanish.
Or like,
I don't know, Mexico.
Mexico.
Let's go Mexico.
So you must like karaoke, right? A little bit
here and there.
And when you do you want to sing Spanish and on those tracks?
I do sometimes.
Okay. All right.
Sometimes depends on how much.
All the Selena tracks.
Yes. Depends on the drinks.
The drinks. What drinks may put you over? Tell us.
I don't know. Sometimes I get a little crazy. I'll do like shots and chase it with beer.
Damn. That's how you get down.
Or I'll do like Blue Moon with peach schnapps.
Blue Moon with peach schnapps.
Mm.
Yeah, try it. It's amazing. Peach Moon.
I will.
Wow. Impressive.
It's really good. Those sneak up on you.
You must have a high tolerance level, right?
I used to.
You must have said,
I
used to.
I'm slowing down now.
You're only 21, so yeah.
Oh, I wish.
Slowing down my ass.
I wish.
Speeding up. It's like a locomotive.
You're not even hitting your prime
I'm slowing
yet,
down
girl.
To speed back up. No.
You're not even near your prime.
I feel like I'm there.
Golly. We need to get you back and on track. But kind of like refine that question that you asked, Cindy. It's more like, because you have different types of hip hop, whether it's Bay Area sound, the more mainstream ratchet feel. What kind of sound are you looking?
Not ratchet.
What would you like to represent mainly?
I love the Bay, but the thing with my music is I don't want to stay in the Bay. You know, I don't want to just be Bay Area. Like, I want it to be something where everyone could listen to.
Sure.
Like
universal.
Universal. I want to go for a universal sound. Mm-hmm. Something where, like, someone in, I don't know, like...
St. Louis.
The UK or someone, you know, like, oh, my gosh, that's what I'm going through. I feel her.
Okay.
You know, not like that, but you know what I mean.
Literally.
Throw some dry ice in there.
And you'll feel that.
There you go. There you go. Cool.
So now you grew up in the Bay, right?
Yes.
All right. So being a Bay Area rapper, is there any other Bay Area rapper that you would like to do a song with?
Bay Area rapper I would like to do a song with.
Sage the Gemini. I am Sue. Do you know anyone that I'm saying? Okay, I just want to make sure.
I'm thinking.
Because they're the most curtain.
Like, who has, like, a sound that I really like? Like
E-40.
E-40. He's
too
really
short.
Good. Too short? Mac Dre.
I want to see what she's going to say.
Mac Dre's pretty dope. I love him.
Dope
like,
and
know,
dead.
Make, like, use his voice as a B and then just come on it.
Yeah.
But E-40, he's really dope. I listen to him a lot.
He's E-40 a legend.
Living he's
legend.
Pretty good.
Okay.
Nice.
Now, how about any singers from the Bay?
I don't know any singers from the Bay. Let's
See, that kind of sucks.
I know there's Keisha Cole.
That's right.
There's Keisha Cole. Who else?
That's about
it. I love Keisha Cole.
Who doesn't? Yeah.
I haven't heard about her in a while.
She did the remix to...
Loyal.
Loyal.
Yeah.
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 Oh, yeah. I would do a spin on that.
Okay.
That would be dope.
Okay.
But yeah, Keisha Cole's really dope. I don't know any other singers.
That's right. It was almost like a little test question, but you're right. There isn't really any R&B singers from the Bay that stands out. Sorry.
Shout out to Dude Damage. He's a singer. Out of the bank.
Thank you. All right, cool. Does that finish it for you, Shani?
It's fine.
Cool. Paul, you get an opportunity to ask AP something.
Oh, you know, she's a wrestler. And I'm sure, like, my know people out there know I'm a wrestler. So, you know, how do you put up with these guys? Did you wrestle like the mountain man? I mean, you know, did you go up the mountain and you got to beat everybody that's, you know, bigger than you?
Yes, I wrestled Yetis and, yes.
The Sasquatches.
Sasquatches, yeah. You
donned a singlet and... I mean, can we look at your ears? You have any, like, you know,
cauliflower
ear?
No, they're fine.
I'm still thinking about a Yeti and a singlet.
He probably has one under here. He knew I was coming. He
uniform.
Wore one
Absolutely.
Today.
We play. We do all these drinks in these uniforms, and yeah, one of them is a singlet.
Oh
nice.
My gosh!
Yeah.
Pictures or it didn't happen.
Extra sweaty one.
Yeah, next sweaty.
Extra sweaty.
Extra sweaty. So that's your question?
The oh,
whole wrestling
yeah, no,
thing?
No. Yeah, no. Yeah. What did you do? Can you tell us about your wrestling? That's pretty cool. Not many, you know.
Artists have a wrestling background.
Artists have a wrestling background.
She's our own security guard.
Yeah. Need one for your shows, bro.
I'm looking.
There you go.
That's us. That's
us. We can do it.
No, I was in history class at Pittsburgh High. And the wrestling coach, he's really good friends with my history teacher. And he comes in, he's like complaining about his wrestlers, this and that. And me and my homegirl at the time, we were like little badasses. We're like, yeah, whatever. Your girls are heck of weak. I bet you will come in there and drop all of them. He's like, oh, yeah, I'm looking for girls. You guys come through. So long story short, we ended up showing up and we dropped like everyone on his wrestling team, all the girls. And he was like,
what?
He was like, I have a tournament tomorrow. Do you want to be in it? And I was just kind of like, sure. What do I do? I didn't know any wrestling moves. I just knew like to pick him up and body slam
him. There you
him.
Go.
So,
yeah.
The basics.
So yeah. So I go to the tournament. I ended up placing fourth.
Awesome.
I
That's
didn't
awesome.
Know. I thought it was like wrestling, like WWE. I was like, this little girl, if she lifts up my leg, I'm going to boot her. My back was on the ground. I didn't know that when your back is flat on the ground,
yeah,
that's
a
pin and
yeah.
you're done. Mm-hmm. I didn't know that. I was just thinking like, oh, she's going to lift up my leg. Watch, I'm gonna choke her out with my legs. But yeah, I lost. So
favorite
I
move? Sport. You have a favorite move?
Bear hug.
A bear hug?
Yes, that's my favorite move.
You were going to say Gramby roll or something.
I'm
going to
YouTube
hugs.
That right now.
Yeah, I don't do any of the leg stuff. I don't go diving for the legs, the single legs, any of
Ankle
that.
Ankle picks.
Yeah, I just get up under their arms, grab them, and slam them.
The best way.
Yeah.
Every
and
guy
it,
likes
I was so out of shape. If I didn't pin him in the first round, I was like, God dang, this is going to be so hard. I ate too many tacos, burritos. This is not going to work. This
yeah.
girl's working me. I never wrestled girls my weight. They were always like 10, 15 pounds heavier than me. So I was like, damn, I'm about to yoke her.
Uh-oh.
And if I don't, she's about to yoke me. But it was fun. It was a great experience. I loved it.
Now, awesome. If you get an opportunity to go professional, yes?
Yes, definitely.
And what there would your
you
nickname
go.
Be?
I don't know.
We got to figure out one, guys. Her wrestling nickname.
AP Slam. That'd be your yeah, move.
That like
that'd,
a,
be your, that'd be your
that
move.
Sounds like a Loco Moco type of breakfast or something.
Slam.
Yeah, the Denny's AP meal slam. And shit. That's funny. So we're about to take a break, and we're going to go into this track that you sent me called Copycat. Now, tell me a little bit more about this.
Copycat's one of the first songs I put out since I started rapping. I wrote a lot of other songs, but Copycat was the first song I released because when I was starting, there was like so much like animosity. There was so much hate that I was getting from like, you know, just other Polynesians. Like, why is she trying to rap? Why does she think she's all this?
Wow.
And then like other girls were like, why does she think she's a model? I never like put myself out there as a model. I just... got asked to do a lot of music videos. I don't know why.
Yeah, opportunity goes to you.
Yeah, and I was just like, hell yeah, I'll do it. Yeah, network.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna make new friends. So I did like at the time Copycat was coming out, I was going through this stage in life where it's like, you know what? My people don't even support me. And then the people who do, like, they're the same people who say they support me or, like, watching what I do, whatever. It's like they try to go take what I do and do it or switch it up or whatever. So that's why I named it Copycat.
Because
It's like you're trying to do what I'm doing, but it doesn't work. Like, not everyone's the same. So you're trying to do what I'm doing. It doesn't work for you. It works for me, You know, because I'm me. But, you know, like, it was just crazy. It was a crazy time. But it came out and a lot of people liked it. And I was like, I like this song. And it was actually pretty dope. My homeboy Kalani made the beat out of, that's a voice sample he made the beat out of. And he's out in Hawaii now. And my boy Cito Crazy recorded it. We recorded this song in the closet. And I'm surprised It came out the way it came out. I was like, wow, we're making magic.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, so it came out and we just got good feedback. So
there you go.
Really excited about it.
Well, we're excited to play it right now here on the Slam Show. This is Copycat by AP, and we'll be right back with the vaunted Q&A for her. We're not sure yet, Joe, what level we're going to go with her on the Q&A.
Uh-oh.
We'll talk about it. Here it is, Copycat by AP here on the Slam Show.
Bitch with the copycat shit. You see, my name is AP. I do things a little different. Make my own rules, cause I'm a solid ass 10. When you see me in the club, you want a piece of this swagger. Sorry, little mama, this a one girl saga. Make a nigga feel special when I walk on by. With a wink and a drink, I got him down to right. You see, nigga shit bricks when I lick my lips. Got $1 million smile for the copycat chicks. Copycat chick, copycat bitch, yeah. Take another flick, I'll just change up the script. Cause I'm a trendsetting chameleon, stuck with bitches I could pee on. I know the game is vicious, it's suspicious how I got it. Sorry, it's my bloodline, that's a chief in me. I'm a natural born leader, I was meant to be boss.
Monkey see, monkey do. Hanging out these vines like gorillas going zoo. You're trying to imitate me, but you're looking like buffoons. You lied about my status cause you wanna be tycoon. I'm Tony the Tiger and his hair is frosted flakes. A dangerous epidemic, I take them out like plagues. I try to keep them quiet, but their mouths just dilate. Copy all you want, but my space don't violate. My lemonade's legit and you come for concentrate. You sneaky little bastards, more poison than a snake. Y'all slither and whisper, I'm fiery blisters. Test me out, cock back, take you out pistol. I speak it and you do with this, the latter, I'm the fluid. This rapid thing to me is like a language speaking fluid. Your flea infested cats eat the trash stop pursuing. I keep it fresh like oxygen, your J-Cast can't stay polluting. Appreciate it, grazie. Life's like a movie, thanks to all the groupies. Yeah. Every time you see me, I got on different faces. Been to many places, I ain't with that fake shit. I'm tired of people hating. Talk about me, put me down, and smile up in my face. Every time I come around, is that the best that you can do? Spread some rumors, make more lies. You really think you got me fooled, bitch? Play the bitch next door, cause I ain't the bitch to play. You just can't keep up, and you've never been me. I make money different ways, and it's not just a phase. Upgrade on a daily, don't this shit sound crazy? And you wonder why they call you a bitch. Cause you stay running around with the copycat shit. Just quit and get a real job, that welfare ain't gonna last long. I'm always gonna be here, the top's where I belong, bitch.
Yeah, that is AP's Copycat. Let's give her a big round of applause. Kind of graphic there in a few lyrics. Got to express it. I like it.
Yeah. I was mad when I wrote that.
Don't hold back.
I was mad.
Don't ever hold back. But yeah, it's dope track. I wish you the very best on all your music endeavors. But you're not off the hook yet, because right now we're going to go into the vaunted Q&A.
Oh, I'm like swaying already. What is this? Some kind of sick joke?
10 questions that you better answer without any hesitation.
Okay.
Show that wrestling fearless on the Vaunted Q&A here on the Slam Show.
Yeah, it's going to be more than them winks and then drinks.
Okay, Mr. Time, go ahead and start with the first one.
All right. At what age did you, pop that cherry? When did you lose your virginity?
18.
18.
I was 18.
All right.
18, 19. 18, I think.
18. You sure it's 18?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, she doesn't remember, then it wasn't remarkable. Right?
That was funny.
All right, number two. Do you own any sex toys?
No.
Would you like to?
Yes, I actually want to buy some.
Okay.
Just never got the time. I need a shopping buddy.
No.
I need a shopping buddy.
Well, pick out one. Not hard. Everyone here is...
Right. Let's go.
This whole wall here is pervert.
Toys.
That was fun.
You have secrets over in Pleasant Hill. Hey, go there, grab... anything, dildo, vibrator, all that. You'll be set.
You have Sarah's Bare Necessities in Concord.
That's right.
That's Shaney's place.
I went there. I went there looking for a penis cake. You know, the
yeah.
Penis
cake.
I like how Paul's birthday. Like, yeah, penis cake.
Did he find
yeah,
it?
There's a party?
She said penis cake, Paul.
That's funny.
Penis cake.
No penises
like,
were harmed in the making of
said
cake.
I want it.
Right on.
All right. Have you ever been in a threesome?
No.
Would you ever be in a threesome?
No.
Really?
I don't know.
Really? You just get like overly jealous and stuff? Like if you see your man poking another woman? Like
I just
envision
know.
That. Is
I
it comfortable?
No.
Who says it would be with another woman? It could be all women.
That's
what I was going to say.
Let's flip it. All women.
That's what I was going
to
say.
Who wants to share a man? Once he's done, he's done. You know?
All right, Cindy, you're making your point clear.
You mad?
So
it was one time.
So all women, possibly?
No.
Really?
Yeah,
even after
really.
A few drinks, what was that favorite drink you like? What was it?
The peach something.
The peach moon. Yeah.
Come on. I mean, after a few of those, weren't you kind of like, let me touch some soft lips?
No, I don't know.
Really?
I can't. Yeah, no,
that's
I can't.
Fun.
Okay, okay.
Do you crave balls after a few drinks, Sam?
I know. Balls over your face.
I have to do it.
What's really going on?
You see Sam,
you're like, oh, man,
me.
I want to go skiing. You know, like...
Hey, did Joe tell you something?
No.
Number four.
It's getting weird.
Hey, that's what the rated X Q&A happens. I told you. You said do it. Number four, what's your favorite sexual position?
Oh, my gosh. I don't know.
Must not be her favorite if she has to think about it.
Yeah, I don't know.
All the above?
No.
Yes,
favorite.
All the above.
Really?
Yes.
No, equal time for each. Right?
So everything on top, all the above.
There you go.
All the above.
All the above.
That's fun.
I don't really have a favorite.
Okay.
Sound pretty adventurous for not owning a dildo.
I have one. No, just kidding. I don't have
one. Okay.
Well, we've got a lot of no's, so let's see if we get a yes out of this one. Do you watch porn, or have you watched porn? And if you do watch porn, or have watched porn, what type of porn was it, or what type of porn do you, prefer?
I don't.
Seen that coming.
I don't. No, I don't.
You don't watch porn, but have you ever?
No.
Never.
Not even a glimpse?
Never.
Not even someone likes it, sent you something, and it's like, click this. It's two girls, and there's one cup. And you're like, click.
No.
Oh,
no one's ever sent me. Who sends people porn? You send people porn?
I've
like,
received.
Oh,
well, I've received.
Porn.
Every other text, huh?
It's like a mass text he sends out every morning. Good morning, y'all. Happy hump day here.
Now, going back to the whole Pacific Islander, huge family, no one's like pulled up on their smartphone and say, hey, check this out, and it was some like weird sex thing.
No.
Really?
You never walked in on somebody?
No.
Oh, this is crazy.
This is interesting.
What about a magazine? You never like seen a magazine?
I was like so respectful. Like we don't do that. Like we don't. Like,
okay.
I don't really watch movies with my brothers and sisters, or with my brothers. With my sisters, it's okay because we're all girls. But like in our culture, we were always like raised like you don't watch movies with your brothers. Mm. You respect your brothers. You're not in their business. Whatever. We don't go out together. You know.
Really.
That's a trip. I never knew.
Yeah,
that.
We're not supposed to. But like I take my nephews out all the time and we get drunk and stuff. But not my brothers. Like it's weird.
I would think that you guys would be even closer because of the style of family. Like, your brothers would always try to be protecting you and wanting to go out with you rather than them having to go out by yourself.
Yeah, like, if we're not, like, drinking or, you know what I mean? But if we're, like, all drinking and, like, we don't want them around, you know? Like, we could get too crazy and they might not like what they see.
They might rat on you to mom and dad.
Yeah, you know, so girls do their things and the guys do their things. So.
Huh.
Only time we'll be out together is probably if we go to a movie, but we won't watch the same movie. Like, we'll all be in different theaters.
That's trippy.
It's different, yeah. There's a super strict. Super strict.
All right, getting back to the rated X questions. Here we go. Number six. Have you ever faked an orgasm?
Yes.
Finally got a yes. And those are actually the words she was saying when she was faking it.
Could have been.
Yes.
Now, do you find that happening more, like, recently?
No.
Okay. So, but you have in the past.
Yeah, a couple of times. Like,
Why
I was
you
just so tired.
Just
want to
go back to what you're doing.
Yeah. Like, fuck. It's like, cool. Yeah, let's go.
Right on.
Okay. We should guess if it's gonna be a yes or no.
Why? No.
Have you had a one-night stand?
Yes.
I seen that one. I would have got it. I would have been like, okay. And then did you fake an orgasm during that time?
Yes.
Oh!
Shout out to you, guy.
Sorry,
bro. You were not worth it.
Oh, my
You
goodness.
Are the weakest link.
If he's watching Bye, this, boy.
Oh, my gosh.
I hope he's in Hawaii.
That's funny.
Oh, no.
I hope he's dead.
I'm trying to narrow it down. The location, the timing.
Oh, my gosh.
That's
He's
cool.
going to go on my Facebook. Sorry, like Where was she around this time?
That's crazy. Number eight. Which three celebrities, guy or girl, that you like to have sex with?
I don't know. I don't know what to say to that.
They wouldn't be at the same time, for sure, though.
That's for... Yeah.
I don't know. I don't find anyone like I don't like really love celebrities like that, or I don't find anyone like I want to have sex with. Like,
there's no other rapper out there that you're
attracted to,
lusting for.
No.
Do they have to still be alive? Hey,
be alive.
Yeah, you want Michael Jackson or Tupac?
Yeah, you know.
They could be a character in a movie.
I don't know. I don't know who to say.
Name one. Name one guy that you just drop everything for.
Or a girl.
Or a girl. Or it could be Yoda.
Right. Okay. How about this guy? The Rock.
I don't know.
It's like a cousin.
Yeah.
That's her uncle. Right? That's her uncle.
I don't date her. I'm Polynesian.
I just wanted to see where you're going to go there.
That's the danger, right? You guys could be
That's
related.
Uncle Dwayne over here.
Joe, you hit it right on the dot, man. Thank you for...
We were just wrestling.
Yeah.
Wrestling.
I was just in his armpit.
Yeah, oh, no. I can smell what the Rock is cooking.
I can smell him right now.
That's funny. Okay. During any of your sexcapades, what was your kinkiest place to have sex?
This can't be a no and a yes question.
Mm-mm, this is like,
Come on,
yeah.
Details.
No, not just kidding.
Details.
Kinkiest place.
She's like, gosh, there's been so many. Which one? The tree?
Remember.
No, or the treehouse?
I don't know, probably the closet.
The closet.
The closet. Closet.
Same one you wrote the album? Song in?
No, it's the closet.
Okay.
Someone else's closet.
Wow, you in closets.
As
huh?
I was like, and then magic happened.
Now, was it because of circumstances, like
sorry,
trying,
really meant.
Trying to hide from the parents, and you got caught up in the closet
no.
situation, or how?
There are no parents there.
Well, how did that come out? Just.
Was it a big closet, or I'm like trying to imagine this closet?
Yeah, a very big walk-in closet.
No, it wasn't that big. It was like
we're talking about the closet. No, I'm just kidding.
That too, I bet.
No, it wasn't even a walk-in. It was just like you're playing, like, just, I don't know how to explain it. Just like a coat closet.
Right, right.
Just hang jackets or put shoes in. I don't know.
So both of you said it was a good idea to go fuck in the small closet, right?
No, we didn't plan it. Like, hey, let's go fuck in that closet. Okay, it just happened. I don't know.
He was like, hey, put your coat in here. Or should I put my coat in here?
And you're come here, bitch.
We're going to Narnia. Take you to Narnia. All right.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm going to use that line. See if it works.
Yeah, let's go in the closet. It's too much. All right, let's close it out with number 10. You ready?
Uh-oh.
Do you spit or swallow?
I thought she was covering her ears.
I was trying to. It just got louder.
Spit or swallow, AP.
She's like, hear no evil.
I don't want to answer that one.
What? No. You said you wanted to do the rated X. So on the slam show, you're all about.
Let me phone a friend.
You're all about wrestling courage.
Well, what's funny is like you don't even got to say nothing, but we have a clip of you saying swallow with the dry ice. Which is loop it in. So it's a real world. So these are real world. That's messed up.
There's no shame in either answer, to be honest. Nah. No.
Okay. So we're leaning towards.
Sam's like.
The no shame answer. They're both no shame.
It's equal?
I feel like they're the same.
Okay, so.
Okay.
That was a yes.
So it was like a yeah.
50-50.
Fair enough.
Okay.
So it's like.
Just depends,
yes.
Right?
We'll
just
take depends. That.
Yes on both occasions.
It depends. If it's in the closet or not.
Yeah, right.
It depends, yeah.
Fair enough.
That was funny.
Okay, AP, congratulations. You made it through the vaunted Q&A alive.
It's hot.
We see you're turning red and shit.
I know.
And all sweating.
My nose.
A few more before we let you go. 3 to 5 years, where do we see AP at? In the movies? In the closet?
In the movie, in the closets.
That's the movie theme right there.
There you go.
No, like hopefully, you know, I'm working on my music. So I eventually want to, you know, get signed. That's my ultimate goal. So I want to be international and, you know, get my music out there, just promote myself. And I feel like that's, you know, my main goal is just to network, you know, more people, you know, pass around your music. You mm-hmm. know, hopefully it falls into the right hands one day, but I'm still going to keep pushing it. Definitely push out some videos soon and, you know, get back into acting. So.
Sex tapes and shit like that, huh?
No sex tapes.
That's one way to get your name out there.
Hey, it's work for everyone else. Paris Hilton, Kim Kardashian.
Yeah.
And they got a record deal. That's stupid.
It's amazing, isn't it? It's freaking amazing. What are domain names that everyone could follow you at and social media?
Instagram, Anna Petta, A-N-A-P-E-T-A. And then on Facebook. I think on there I have my Facebook, but it's a.p.tangitau, which is TANGITAU.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Right on. So hang tight because you will be the co-host on this next segment because we're going to have Paul and Leia of How You Bean Beverages show us a little magic here on the Slam Show.
Oh, I can't wait.
Well, we'll be right back here. Stay tuned.
Double fist.
Make every minute worth it, babe. This for Arsha, babe. Watch this. I done been around the world. I done kissed a lot of girls, so I'm guessing that it's true. Make me holler and I bet $1 million. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Bang, bang, bang.
Smoking
don't
in
nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you.
Rebel without a cause. No umbrella, the money stuffed in the doors. Rodell Drive, money oldest Clive Davis. Blue paper still chasing dead faces. Dark tints, rims chopped like razors. 2 mil to the side for the cases. Boss, pinky ring both hands. Moskowitz wanna lean on a man. Peter Pan got X-Stop plans. Little homie still be moving like the Fed. My Spanish chick be on that Telemundo. Pretty face and she got the fattest culo. Kissing all on me, tension all on me. Touch a little paper, start switching all on me. I'm looking for the best kiss with a passport. It's time to get missing. Boss. Boss.
I done been around the world, I done kissed a lot of girls, so I'm guessing that it's true. Yeah. Make me holler and I bet $1 million, don't nobody kiss it like you.
Don't nobody kiss it like you, don't nobody kiss it like you.
Bang, bang, bang. Don't nobody kiss it like you,
don't nobody kiss it like you.
This girl, she my hero, get it, hero, euros, pesos, spice and yen.
I ain't wanna check off either.
I'm staring. Your barrel, pull the trigger,
chitty, chitty, bang, bang.
I told her, the devil is a lie.
Them other girls can't compete with mine.
You do it so good, you move my mind.
You pull it out, then you open wide.
You make me want to tap out every time.
Your pretty lips leave me so inspired.
I think I got a winner, could be a keeper, cause she's such a good
kisser.
We be kissing all night. Been around the world, I done kissed a lot of girls, so I'm guessing that it's true. Make me holler and I bet $1 million, don't nobody kiss it like you.
Yeah, that's brand new Usher featuring Rick Ross. Good kisser, AP. Yeah. Yeah, here on the Slam Show. Welcome back. And we have our second interview segment, always sponsored by Little J's Burgers over here in Pittsburgh. Props out to Aaron.
The best tri-tip in town.
Awesome.
So good.
Awesome. So check them out.
Today. It was so good. Really good.
Orgasmic.
It was orgasmic.
That's the way we do it here on the Slam Show. All right. I have a little picture of their stand. This company hails from the city of Tracy. We first met over at the Fiesta event car show in Sacramento, I just fell in love with those volcanic drinks. And I said to myself, we need to get these motherfuckers here on the Slam Show. And sure enough, they have made the trip. Let's have a big round of applause for Paul and Leia of How You Bean Beverages.
Yeah, we came. We're bringing it down a notch from the last one. You said we brought you up 20 notches.
Mm-hmm.
We'll bring you up 20 notches when you're ready, but not right about now. We're just going to just show a little bit of what we do and what we did for Filipina Fiesta. It was big, huge car show. Made a big donation shout out to everybody in the Philippines who was in that.
Yeah, the typhoon disaster.
It was just devastating. And so we're just super. It was our second year in a row to be a part of something like that. So
yeah, thank you for participating.
Salamat.
There you go. Stay rooted there, Joe.
Not bad. Pretty cute.
So let's kind of back up. How'd you get into the whole drink business?
So I was in IT, and I was being outsourced again. And I was like, I just don't want to go through outsourcing anymore. And I listened to everything CEO and VP said, and I was like, man, I think I could run a business. They gave me a bunch of money to leave, and I said, all right, that's it. I'm going to start a business. And I was choosing between, you know, it was either all natural dog treats or this. And so this vice president was like, you know, you should just choose one. You choose dogs or you choose drinks. And so I figured drinks was with people, and I really love people. And
well, you already got a fan with Cindy here because she is a major dog lover and participator of activities. Because
dogs, fishing, right?
There you go. I know. There you go.
Maybe you could do both in the future.
We could. We could do both. Could, absolutely. We'll bring our dogs on the boat.
Out of the fish
we'll
catch, we could make the treats.
Absolutely.
And you could have Cindy run to that dog division.
There you go.
You could run the dog division.
The CEO of the dog division.
Yeah. No, I did. I wanted to make all natural, like, you know, just everything organic from fresh. So, and by the way, we got one all natural beverage out of the three because, you know, Lady Sage was saying how she thought one was, you know, like Kool-Aid with ice. So we're going to make you guys, you know, we're going to test you too. So you got to know which one is like the real fruit.
Wow.
Yeah.
We're being tested.
What if you don't care if it tastes good?
Well, you know, you got to care. It's got to be good.
Right? I mean, what if you don't care if it's Kool-Aid or if it's juice, as long as it tastes good?
Oh, yes. No. That's
all
true.
That matters,
that's true.
Right?
That's true. And you know, we do a lot for schools, and so we want to really educate about this product as well. And,
right.
You know, a lot of moms, teachers, and you know, they grow you up saying, you know, dry ice is gonna burn your face off, and so they won't let their kids near it, and so I have to actually grab it for them and say, oh no, it's not gonna, you know, it's not like you were taught. So there's just so much misinformation about
a lot of myths,
this gas, and a lot of myths, and we just break them.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Now, when you wanted to start the whole beverage company, was it primarily this idea that you have, or did it evolve to it?
This evolved, actually, yeah.
So it started out what?
Coffee.
Just coffee.
It started out strictly coffee at a train station.
Okay.
In Tracy. And I just
Amtrak?
No, it was the ACE train, the Altamont Commuter Express. And I just wanted to serve the people. I was a commuter, and I just knew that, you know, they're gone all this time from their families, at least 12, 13, 14 hours a day when you commute on a train.
Right.
So you become, you know, just comrades. You're just a tight-knit bunch of you know, people, and I just wanted to bring them something great, and so coffee was it, and they love me. I still get hit by, you know, Elizabeth Tidd, shout out to you, because I know you're rocking it tonight and watching me. She's like my all-time longest, you know,
customer.
Fan of our company. Yes.
Awesome.
Yes. So if you're ever on Facebook, you know, and you see Elizabeth Tidd, that's who Elizabeth Tidd is.
Okay.
Yeah.
Everyone, add Elizabeth Tidd.
Add her. Oh, she commented on everything. Tidd. Yes, she's awesome.
There you go. Yeah. Do it right now, AP, please. So you're still doing the coffee stuff along with the volcanic drinks, correct?
Right.
All right. And let's get down to it. What is those drinks that you're making, all the dry ice effect and stuff like that? Because when I first tried it, I was like, this thing is awesome. It's just, it looks cool. And I was hammered to shit and I kept on going back for more.
It's addicting.
It is.
Yeah.
It is. So explain how you made the concept of it reacting the way it does and making it safe for people to consume.
Yeah. So we're much more into organics now than we are into, you know, non-organic stuff. So we still favor the coffee. We still go deep into the coffee. We use coffee has gone around the United States of America, our company, with companies that really want high end, you know, brew bars, their special way of making coffee. And so that's really what we do. Then we took that to stadiums. About 5 years ago, 6 years ago, we took it to stadiums, and the stadiums loved us, and the stadium said, look, we saw this thing one time, and I don't know, there was smoke coming out, and you could duplicate this thing. You're forever here at this stadium. So we're like, all right, let's go to work. We went into the garage, not the closet, but the garage.
Let's go, man.
Where everything happens, and so We designed the drink. We made the juices ourselves. We brought it back to, it was the A's minor league stadium. So for everybody watching, if you went out to the ports, you know, that's where we started this thing at. And now we've taken it, you know, the multi-state and all over the place. So, we put in frozen carbon dioxide. We like to let you guys know it's frozen carbon dioxide. The nickname is dry ice. So the people can get to know that carbon dioxide is a gas, it's an element in our atmosphere, And here, I should just pull some out and show you guys. But basically, this, you know, it's in this room. It's everywhere. Big machines pull it out. I don't know if you guys can, oops, sorry, see all this. But anyway, big machines, like the size of a fuselage of a 747, pull it out of the air. And then they clean it. I'm not supposed to tell you, but it's like an ammonia cleaner. It's
what?
Anyway, yes, I know. But it cleans it to such a super quality grade that it's above food grade. Mm-hmm. So it's a beverage grade, which is above food quality. So they compress it in these big tanks that are the size of a 747, which turns it to a liquid.
Mm-hmm.
They introduce that liquid to oxygen, O2, as pure as possible, and then instantly it turns to the frozen solid state, you know, this carbon dioxide. And now you see the sublimation coming off of it. So it looks like it's smoking, but it's actually sublimation. It's actually going from a hard solid back to its vapor, its gas state. So again, a lot of times, right, the people think it's so cold, and, you know, but you actually can touch it if you just kind of play with it a little bit fast.
That's what she said.
I was going to bring back up the closet thing.
hey.
But yeah, no, it's not like your teacher told you. It's not like your parents told you. It is cold. It is -109.3 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
It's cold, but it's like
AP. Hold it.
Yeah, sure. Like, just hold it and kind of just.
Hot potato.
Yeah, like a hot potato. Oh. Actually, she's got wrestler hands. I can feel them. She's she's got tough hands.
Construction hands.
So,
oh wow.
So what happens when it goes into these drinks is that the drink starts to transform. So carbon dioxide,
like the movie.
Just like the movie, it's a transformer drink, and you know, well,
just like that,
just like makes that noise. Just
yeah,
like
I could tell if you put
actually,
it too long
it
on
goes.
Your hand, you will.
Yeah,
it's gonna.
It, right?
Yeah, it'll go through.
It'll go through.
Actually, that's some like freaking quantum.
No,
I'm sorry.
Does.
Go ahead.
No, it does. No, that's metal. We need a real piece of metal, but it will make metal vibrate.
Wow.
Yeah. So you can have your own vibrator. I mean, who needs to go to the store?
I don't think I'd want to put that in my bag.
No, I don't think you want to put that. There you go.
That sounds very
the metal.
Unpleasant.
Gotcha. Yeah.
So.
Okay.
So, yeah. Basically, carbon dioxide's a carbonator, and it's going to go into these beverages. It's going to transform three properties. It's going to transform the texture.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to start to get fizzy. It's going to transform the temperature. So it starts off lukewarm, tepid, maybe 110 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden it goes down, you know, it's -109. So it's going to go down to it'll actually, if you put in too much dry ice, the whole thing turns to a big ice cube.
All right.
Wow.
Yeah. So
okay. So let's see it in action.
So the smaller the granules, the more explosion it you're going to have.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not really going to explode. I mean, we could explode something like with a lid on it, and we got all.
Well,
the
let's
bottles,
not take too many chances here.
All right,
Paul.
It's a tame show.
Yeah.
Just put a big old scoop with a dust in it.
Yeah, right a big old
here.
Get in there,
get
Leia.
In there.
Get in there. Scoop that shit.
Ooh.
Oh!
There you go.
Woo. Yeah.
All right. So,
look at it
oh,
go.
That's so cool.
Yeah, this is what you get.
That's and, awesome.
And that's just a little bit of liquid in there, maybe about a quarter
it's
of a
nice
gallon.
It's cool, too.
Yeah, it definitely is cool.
Right? It's cool.
And when we put in the flavor, it'll actually smell like the flavor.
Mm-hmm.
So we brought you a watermelon and a lemon and a cherry, and so it's going to taste and smell the same.
That's awesome.
All right, and maybe if our gorgeous Leah here can you make us some drinks?
I feel like
loveliest
just carrying thing. That. Putting my top down on my convertible and just driving around with that shit. Just fucking shooting freaking smoke everywhere.
Exactly.
Way to trick the cop.
Yeah, it's like, I'm just rolling. I'm bad.
Yeah,
it's a freaking steam convertible. That is cool.
Yeah, so it's going to take about a minute and a half to start changing to a soda. So just, you know, you can drink it while it's tepid and warm on a cherry.
Oh, sure.
Because I heard, like, we're not going to go there with the most sexy jokes,
but now,
something about a cherry was
while Leia's putting together the drinks for us, is there any other companies that are, like, in competition with you doing this stuff, or are you the sole one?
No, there's actually been a couple. There's actually one in Sacramento. He started for a while back in the beginning. So many of them have tried to duplicate this, but running a company is, you know, it's different to run a company and then add a big drink like this.
Mm-hmm.
To your product line already, it's really tough. So, For us, we're a drinking, we're a beverage company, but a food company was just really tough. It's a lot to bring.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, it's its own thing.
Yeah, and there's different permits for that as well, right?
Well, you know, it is different because this one, there's nothing to clean, and it's really all about being clean, and if you're going to, you know, screw up the environment or, you know, people are going to drink it and die.
Yeah, yeah.
And the health department comes in and like, oh, my gosh, it's dry ice. Everybody here is going to die. We got to shut down the whole park.
Well, I would have died a long time ago because I drank like four of those over at the Fiesta. I was like loving it. I was like freaking barely walking. I'm like, Paul, hook me up another one, please. Hook me up. This is just good. I love you. You're going on. So
awesome. We did all day.
And yeah.
What you know about that?
Perfect dance move. But he played the perfect music to just, right? It was just perfect. Everything was perfect.
Thank
that
you.
Day was
Thank
great.
You. Well, they got me because I was able to play a little bit of the old stuff and the current stuff and have
that
good balance. That.
Actually, that was very impressive that you mixed that old stuff in there. It was awesome.
Thank you.
Really cool. Yeah, you get another one. There you go.
No, I was going to pass it over here.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, AP. Look at that. Look at that. It's moving. It is moving.
I'll take one, yeah.
Lemon. Oh, it went up my nose.
Mm. Yeah, so it is an expansive gas, so if good. It can go up your nose, but it's, you know, it's just expanding.
Yeah,
it makes
so
you feel it.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
And this is not just for you guys at home. It's not a bong. We are not like.
You can't even
it's
drink.
Like that 70s shows. We're all in the room.
Yeah.
You know what I like about
it? This is THC coming out of
here. Oh my goodness! If that was THC, if this was weed, we'd be all. This would be a fucking crazy show.
Let it begin.
We would have so many like freaking air breaks. Like, what'd you
we'd
say?
We'd have a lot of breaks. Yeah.
What'd you say? Did I say that? So.
I would definitely get to be talking.
What flavor is this?
That's watermelon.
Okay.
Yeah, tastes like a Jolly Rancher watermelon.
Yeah.
It's so good. We just, that one came out of a girls' event.
So good. Mm-hmm.
They wanted pink, and we gave them pink, and it was so awesome and such a hit that we just added it to our lineup.
The pink poodle.
The pink poodle.
The pink poodle.
Sydney was like, I applied there. Yeah.
It's good. That was good.
So, to get back on track, are there any, like, variations of how the volcanic reaction display is there anything that you're going to try to do differently other than what we're getting right now?
You know, we've dabbled and played in, it's a molecular gastronomy is the name, so I'm going to test you guys later. Molecular gastronomy is when you take a gas and you change a food or a beverage item with a gas. This is technically molecular gastronomy. We're
changing it to soda.
We're changing it to a soda.
Mm-hmm.
And so we've actually done ice cream. We've done it for a couple of companies that had, you know, some ex-49ers were there,
mm-hmm.
were their VCs, and we made ice cream for them in different flavors.
I'm glad it's the 49ers, not no Raiders.
Yeah, I know.
No
the Raiders
ice cream for
us
them.
Up, yeah.
How do they can afford it?
Black ice cream.
No, they can't afford it.
We love the Raiders, too.
I'm outnumbered now.
Definitely.
You've always been outnumbered.
No.
Raider fan.
Whatever.
Oh, I just fell out of love with Shaney.
This is awesome.
So did you guys try them all?
No.
Well, I thought it was just ours.
Oh.
Yeah. I forgot to share. I apologize.
Who shares
to
share?
Are we sharing? Are we sharing?
You don't have to share. You can keep it all to yourself if you want.
No, but who's it? Is this new?
No, I tried that one.
Oh, yeah.
Can I have my own?
Sure.
Yeah,
sure,
please.
Sure, sure.
Please. Not that you have any cooties or anything, AP. I just wanted my own. So
I'm sure.
I am
okay.
A germaphobic,
this is
nobody's
though. Touched it.
Really? You're like Howie Mandel?
Yeah, I don't share drinks with people.
Oh, my goodness.
Nope.
What have germs done to you?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, because I haven't let them do anything to me.
Wow. This is awesome. And what flavor is this again?
That's lemonade.
Lemonade.
Yeah, that's like really, really.
What did I have?
Lemonade. I don't remember. It's a sourness, but it's lemons.
I think it was red. Cherry's good.
Oh, this is awesome.
Cherry and vodka is definitely the bomb. That's
cherry vodka.
The cherry and vodka.
Ladies and gentlemen, you got to get one of these. That's for sure. And do you go, obviously, you'll do private parties, right? Not necessarily corporate events?
Yeah, and you could eat it a little bit. You can eat it in small amounts. You don't want to take big ones. But, yeah, we do a lot of parties.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're, like, talking with the ice in
it. Yeah, I got some ice in my mouth. And it is a gas, so wherever the ice, wherever it goes in, it's coming out. So just don't swallow it because you're going to be know, I'm coming out of it everywhere.
Fart.
Have you ever, like, swallowed dry ice on accident?
Probably, yeah.
Hey, you're alive, so I guess it's not fatal.
Yeah, I eat it quite a bit. So if you ever had Pop Rocks, it's Pop Rocks.
Yeah.
Yeah, Pop Rocks pop out of your mouth, and you make all the little gases, and Pop Rocks has carbon dioxide in it. So, yeah. So we do take your kids to work day with big companies. Companies want to, they call it the J Cloud, or the, which is Juniper, and, you know, NetApp, and a lot of companies like, you know, the cloud's the end thing right now.
Mm-hmm.
So we do a lot of work for even for, like, venture capital firms.
Awesome.
And they want to show off some of their cloud computing companies that are within, that are in their portfolio. Okay. And they'll have us come out and do all these drinks.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Thousands and thousands. We do it for donations as well. So Rocket Fuel's a company that hires us about 10, 12 times a year.
Mm-hmm.
And we probably help them donate just tens of thousands of dollars a year to different organizations. They're a huge company, just a company that just loves to give. So we partner with people like that.
That's great. Yeah. That's great. Well, enough of me asking questions. I'll go ahead and have my co-hosting staff, starting with Joe, take it away. I enjoy my lemonade volcanic drink.
No, I'm really at awe about everything. Like, this is beautiful. I mean, everything was, like, cooling, like she was saying earlier. Like, in the summertime, you could just feel it, you know. It's not just cooling internally. It's cooling on your face when you're just chilling with it.
Yeah.
It smells good.
It's an exfoliator.
But it's an exfoliator.
That's why you look so good right now.
Why, thank you, Mr. Paul. Biggest question I really wanted to ask, you know, because I'm a really big fan of Robert Kiyosaki as well, and just kind of explain, like, his teachings and what it took you to take this business to the next level, if there's any, like, nuggets that you can kind of share with us.
Yeah, so I started out. So basically, what happened with Robert Kiyosaki is I played this board game. This
cash flow.
Older couple, yeah, cash flow.
So
and,
awesome.
And so I was at church, and this couple's like, you know, you could be millionaires, and I think you got it. And, you know, I'm like, I don't got it. We just came back from Japan, and she was still 5 years old, and so I mean, I was like, oh, life sucks. And then this couple just came, and we played this game, you know, cash flow 101.
Yeah.
And the man, I tell you, the lights just went on in my head.
Beautiful.
And I got the book in CD form and you know, the four quadrants of the cash flow quadrant, which is the next one. And I just was just, everything was food. Everything was life to me that he was speaking. And so I just kept at it God, I want to go from the left side of the quadrant. I don't know if you guys know your cash flow quadrant, but you know, the employee and the self-employed, mm-hmm. over to the the entrepreneur top side and top right, and then into an investor. And so I eventually want to be an investor.
Get out of the rat race.
Eventually we'll be out of the rat race.
That's awesome, man. Congratulations on everything. And I wish you much success. And this is beautiful. Can't wait to see more of this everywhere.
Awesome. Awesome. Thank you.
What would be your dream event to bring this to?
The Super Bowl.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. And you know
the World Cup.
And every year that changes. It really changes. So, I wanted to be at Stagecoach, and we got Stagecoach. I wanted to be at Harley Strictly Bluegrass. We've been in Harley Strictly Bluegrass. And so I'd say, you know, I guess I'm shooting for some Vegas shows.
EDC?
You know, iHeart, EDC.
EDC.
But, you know.
Spearmint Rhino?
If they're going to drink at all. Do they drink anything? Or just...
Yeah, it's more of a drug.
It's just party. Yeah. Then,
but I mean, if they're tripping balls, they might like it. They might just buy it, even if it doesn't have alcohol in it, because they'll be hot if they're on, you know, if they're on Molly or something.
Yeah, they need it at the end of the night. Molly,
we
right?
don't endorse that, by the way.
Yeah, no.
We don't endorse them using it, but we'll profit off people's other stupid
we're just
choices.
Here to serve, yeah. Right?
We're right?
Just here to serve. We don't care what you do, who you are. We love you, and
it's free will.
We just want to serve you.
I mean, we can give them. This or Valtrex, you know, like there's a market for everything.
Yeah, but I'd say, you know, that you know, or iHeart. I think some of those would be just, you know, we've been to some of the such big shows. I think I just want to go stores and kind of, you know, have people be able to come and get it anywhere, not just, you know, not just at an event. Yeah.
Mine's like farting.
Well, it kind of is. Right?
Yeah.
Speaking music,
Yeah, what's happening is being covered by the ice, and it's forcing, it's trying to get the gas through the ice, so you're hearing that. And it's carbonated now, right?
Yeah. Awesome.
I mean, it's right. Doesn't it just get better and better? You just keep drinking it, and carbon dioxide just enhances that flavor.
And if there was alcohol, boy, this will be turned up.
Oh, we would have a whole nother show.
There was alcohol in here.
Cool.
So, you said you're adding flavors. And is it something that you're going to keep on adding different flavors? Or is there any other step with everything you have now? Is there a next step towards something else with the same business?
I think we're going to stick this one just kind of as it is, because our organic coffee is that whole side of the business is booming.
Okay.
And when we go to San Francisco, to be honest, they just really line up for our coffee and our brew
bars.
So
that's the real thing.
That's the real thing.
This is kind of like a little side fun.
This was, again, we did it for the A's minor league stadium, and you know, it's such a fun drink. So we can't, you know, not do it. It's just way too much fun. But definitely organics and our green juices. I mean, we have a sweet green. So,
okay.
You know, we want people to be healthy, and those are definitely products that bring us a lot of attention on a healthier level, which is kind of our heart.
Okay. That's awesome. Cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
Do you guys
Good
only
job.
Have one cart?
We have five carts, and then we have a facade. So what you're seeing up on the screen for everybody that was out there was the was a picture of that was actually with Off the Grid in San Francisco, and that's a really it's a street food company, right? Off the Grid's pretty well known.
Yeah, all the taco trucks and
yeah, all the trucks. So we do a lot of work with Off the Grid.
It's like gourmet food now too. It's not just like tacos and stuff, right? The Off the Grid.
They only do kind of fusion-y gourmet.
Yeah.
You know, you get a lot of really high end chefs that come out of the restaurants now, and they go into trucks and they go around with them. So
isn't there like something by I want to say like North Point or like Marina Green that they have like once a week or something? They have
Fort
all
Mason.
The trucks.
Yeah, I mean, tons of different places actually.
Yeah, okay. they have that over in Walnut Creek as well.
Soma Street Food.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
Yeah. Yeah, on Main Street.
Yeah, they just started coming to Walnut Creek.
Another field trip.
They're branching out.
There you go.
Field trip.
You're driving. That's
no,
for
I'm
sure.
Not driving.
AP, take it away.
I'm very interested in this dog treats because I have dogs, and
awesome.
Like for Christmas, someone bought me this make your own dog treat thing where you put in like the recipes, you close it, and it makes a dog treat.
Cool.
I want to know like what kind of dog treats were you.
So,
like interesting.
So the Robert Kiyosaki of the dog world was a Three Dog Bakery, and I don't know if you're familiar with Three Dog Bakery, but you know, look it up. At, you know, they were.
Is that a Chinese food restaurant? No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. The Three Dog Bakery.
Cindy, go on your smartphone. Figure it out real quick.
Yeah, that's cool. But you know, they started out with all natural dog treats. They cooked them on the spot in their stores. You could go out to like Sutter Creek and Pleasanton, and you know, so we kind of wanted to be like the next Three Dog Bakery, and except take it to the next level and even be raw and you know, we liked raw food for the dogs as well, so it didn't have to always be cooked. But I got the Three Dog Bakery cookbooks and then just modified them to what I liked, and we baked and baked and baked, and we took out all the cornmeal and we replaced it with, you know, other healthier options.
Like
for,
coconut flour and stuff like that.
No, we didn't give them coconut.
I looked up for
could.
How
for
a chocolate.
Dogs. For my dog's first birthday, I looked up to try to make like a whole organic non-grains because he can't have grains and stuff like that. And I made him a birthday cake.
Aww.
Nice. Yeah.
Yeah, we make our dog's birthday cakes too.
But of course, he only got one piece and I threw it away because, I mean, his stomach didn't like it. But it looked really good.
Neither did
he enjoyed
carpet.
It as he did.
Was the husband the dog?
What?
I don't know. You said you made a whole cake for... Did
for
you
my dog.
For your dog. Oh.
His name's Rocky, so
Young
I
Rock.
Made him two boxing gloves, and it was the shape of two boxing gloves, and it was a cake.
Awesome. Good job.
Yeah.
Right on.
So I do love baking. I love cooking. I love everything about foods, but I really like high-end. When people just try to put their spin on it and make it special and take their time with it and real passion for their craft, it's, you know, you're going to suck me in.
Cool. All right. Before we go on to our break, which will bring on the vaunted Q&A, what's in store for you 3 to 5 years from now?
Stores. Stores are, I'm already looking in San Francisco in the Mission District. We're looking for storefronts and partners and, I mean, not just financial partners, but just, you know, all our workers are all partners. And, you know, we need the right workers in place. We've got our business plan. And so I think stores will just stabilize our whole environment and gives us, we need a face.
Mm-hmm.
And people want us to, they want to see more of how you've been. Not just at an event and then goodbye, you know, we can't wait to see you again, and they follow us.
Yeah.
But, yeah, stores are in our future.
How'd you come up with the name?
How you been? Oh, man.
How you been?
we were brainstorming this, and a guy named Tyler Takahashi. So when we were all leaving the company, we just I told him I'm going to – they were going on to other IT jobs, and I'm going on to business. And we started writing down all these names. And, of course, I'm in Central Valley, so I'm like – Pony Express or, you know, train something, some, everything was so dumb. And so finally, you know, we got together and, and Tyler's like, let's just think out the box. And he just started coming up with these bean names. And so Tyler Takahashi, I know you're probably not watching, but I'll record this for you.
Tyler, how you been, bro?
He invented the name, how you been?
Okay. Nice. So he gets a trademark credit for that, correct?
No.
You already paid him out like $500 here. That's it.
Yes. He can have anything else, though.
Unless he invests.
That's right. And
that's
he probably
true.
Could now.
And we will definitely here on the Slam Show invest in you.
Oh, man. Thank you. Okay. Really good.
You got stock and everything all
awesome.
Set up?
We actually do have shares of stock in a corporation. Yeah.
Okay.
Is MZ Hammer part of that?
I wouldn't go into business with the hammer.
What?
We've been into business before. And
oh, yeah.
He doesn't know, but we've done a couple of failed, you know, investments together.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
With Mr. Stanley Burrell.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we actually live only a couple blocks from each other.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because of Tracy and so forth.
Yeah.
How's he doing? You see him, like, wave to
you
over on the street?
You know what? I see him at events here and there. He's told me I have the best coffee he's ever had, and that's all that kind of matters. He's still a superstar. He still really, you know, keeps – he's
to
quiet.
Himself, yeah.
Yeah, he keeps to himself. He's a very quiet man, and –
he's not out in clubs, hoes and clothes, and all that.
You know,
hoes
I think he clothes. Leaves that to his kids.
Okay.
Yeah. I think
the kids are doing the partying for him?
They're doing all the partying for him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotta keep it going.
Gotta keep it legit.
Gotta keep Hammer Time going.
Legit.
All right. We're gonna go ahead and take a quick music break, and it's your turn on the hot seat.
All right.
Mr. Vogt.
He's all for it.
Everyone, stay tuned here on the Slam Show.
She by the floor, brushed up on her like I'm sweeping up. Effortless swag, the plus, already seen enough. Cause how she wanted, good with moves that she making. For all's attention, I'm drawing it like I'm illustrating. A man scoping, but avoiding the conversation. But if it's action, I'm at it, fuck all the conversation. The club jam packed out of control. Whenever she hitting the road, I be the she chose. If you a hot headed, I'll leave her out in the cold. In with the new, out with the old. Cause I'm
out with my old chick.
Thought you knew.
In with my new chick.
Something new.
Heard your man trying to talk. Sh- ain't never gone do sh-
not it.
No, what you saying
yeah.
now?
Yeah.
Say you got a man now. I ain't worried about your man now.
Nah.
Around with me, I put you on.
what you want is what I will do. I see your body right, gets on them certain nights, you got them skills too. Besides the lust, I'm trying to build too. And know the deal, nowadays get exposed, showing the real you. Cause I done seen it all from in the making, been with him. Now she a good friend's new relation. Jeff, but I didn't face him. Probably would never kick it with her. Claim my holy sister, but go around and any certain that was peak as before. To really be honest, the type I ain't seeking no more. So even if she with a man, I have her reaching for show. Probably salute her when I reach through the door. Like,
I with my old chick.
I thought you knew.
And with my new chick.
Something new.
Heard your man trying to talk. Sh- ain't never gone do sh-
not
it. No, what you saying
yeah.
Now?
Yeah.
Say you got a man now. I ain't worried about your man now.
Oh, brother. That was brand new Jinsu featuring Eric Billinger out with the old here on the Slam Show. And boy, we have a very unique Q&A coming up right now. And I don't know what else to say about this one. Just like it sounds, it's going to be eerie.
Great. Don't take it easy on me.
10 questions we're going to ask.
This is funny.
Mr. Bean. In connection to his business.
He's the Bean King. We all have our Bean name.
Okay.
Yeah, so Free Bean.
Okay.
And we got the Bean King. We've got String Bean.
All right.
Who else?
Can everyone here on the show be honorary? Beans?
So you have to. We have to give you the name. You can't. You can't get your own bean name. We got to select it for you.
All right.
Yeah. And then
you're select it for us.
Yeah. So then it'll be official. All right. I'll select it. I'll have to.
We'll do it down. We have a lot of time. We'll pick.
Yeah. During the down, choose everyone. We'll do it during the down. During the next commercial, we'll bring some our bean names.
Honorary bean name.
Honorary.
We have a bean registry too.
Do you really?
We do. We have an official bean registry.
Like, and you can be Beaner.
You need to jump in, Bean. We already got that one. It's done. Both of those are gone.
That's funny.
And people want those.
Jump in, Bean.
Being around the block.
Being around the block.
Yeah. I can't wait till I get my nickname. That's for sure. Okay,
the
I'll
Bean
go.
Team, we call the Bean Team in, and you guys can call me on my secret bat phone because I know you're watching. Let's get these guys some Bean names.
The
Come
Bean
on,
phone.
Text them to me.
All right. Simple enough.
All right. You going to start it off, Sammy?
Yes, I will.
All right.
Number one.
Yes. Yes.
We're already
there. Oh, here we go. Here we go. You ready? And Leia, cover your ears, please.
Earmuffs. Earmuffs.
Yes. How many girls have you slept with roughly in your entire life?
Roughly.
I know. I'm just so boring. And it could be guys. How do you know?
That wasn't the good.
I should freaking change that, huh?
Make it just say people, right?
People. Yeah.
There you go, people. About 7.
That's pretty modest.
And it's about 7.
Okay. Fair enough.
7, okay.
And I believe you.
Yeah, no.
I fucking believe you.
He's a bean counter.
Hey, you don't know. He's making these drinks. You don't know.
I can count beans. I can count those.
Oh, man.
All right. Have you been with a woman or had sex with two women within 12 hours of each other?
Never have.
Never.
Doesn't mean I don't want to.
That's what I'm saying. The way you said it was
I know
like,
what your next question was.
Man.
Like, that's not a bad idea.
Now, the same girl within 12 hours or more, yes.
Yeah, oh, you're like.
There you go.
Yeah. Chest up high and like, yeah, of course.
Absolutely,
but,
everybody.
Yeah. But not different juices within a 12-hour span.
No,
okay.
No.
All right. No. All right. Good.
A little bit of dry ice in the system.
Yeah. No flare-ups.
Have to be a little more, yeah,
no STD flare-ups.
Juice and dry ice.
There you
yeah.
go.
Number 3. At what age did you lose your virginity?
Now, at what age I actually lost it and what age I said I lost it was like totally different. But no, I lost it at 17.
Okay.
So when was the
so you beat AP
unofficial? It was like 5th grade.
So you beat AP by 2 years.
Beat you by 2 years?
Yeah, What was it? 19 or 18?
18.
Yeah, it could have been a year and a half.
it was just all the freaking drinks.
It was all the drinks.
Yeah, it yeah. just created a blur.
And my first wasn't in the closet, though.
All right.
Oh, my goodness.
That's funny. How often do you visit the strip club?
Shoot, I know. You know what?
I know this.
Do you know it?
No, I thought you said that. Like, I know this one.
Yeah.
I know. I rehearsed this one.
So I've actually been to a strip club like maybe 8 times
in your life.
In my life. And like 7 of them have all been like since I've had this business.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Now, would you like to have the business in a strip club?
Would I like these drinks in a strip club? I think it would be pretty awesome.
I would think so too.
Yeah, yeah. Because there's a lot of those non-alcoholic ones, non-alcoholic strip clubs.
Cindy, can you help them out with that?
I think you have to have both.
Well, yeah, like if you go to the all-nude clubs and they don't allow alcohol.
Exactly.
You need something fun, something kind of festive. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I mean, obviously if we go to the ones that do have alcohol, that would be like for an event or like something that's press covered.
Boom.
Yeah, no, I think it'd be slamming, Sam.
It'd be slamming, Sam.
Let's see.
A little cash cap.
You could go to Sapphire, Crazy Horse.
I don't even know where they're at.
Quit playing it off. You know exactly what the fuck
Sapphire's
I'm saying.
Sapphire's in Vegas. There's a Crazy Horse in San Francisco and in Vegas. Mm-hmm.
These are the prime spots.
Once. I'm trying to get there.
You're slipping up, Paul.
I know. These sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. I'm so boring.
That's why he said give me the X-rated one.
Go ahead.
Number 5. Yeah. Your favorite alcoholic beverage?
A vodka.
Just vodka, straight.
Just,
Ricky.
So you pull out everything right now to make a volcanic freaking vodka. Yeah. Just.
We do have a name. We call him a Vodcano. I know, maybe. Ooh. I'm not supposed to pull that name out on the show. But
that's
we're
a sexy name.
X-rated shit. I can say Vodcano.
Pull out the Vodcano.
Yeah, all right.
I like it.
The I think his has alcohol.
I know.
Something funny's going on. I'm over here like, fuck. He's over here like, I hit me with another one, motherfuckers.
Oh, that's hilarious.
AP, you might be absolutely right. He is acting kind of comfortable.
He's like, Leah, here, you know what to do.
But I'm kind of feeling that way, too, so maybe you spike me as well.
I think yours has some.
Aww. Rupees for everyone.
Yay.
You know, what a way to get
down. My crew knows me. They know I don't play around. I'm going to like, yeah, I'm gonna slip something in your drink.
That was my next question. Have you ever roofed? No, I'm just.
He's all, yes, Slam and Sam.
Yeah, right. Have you ever grabbed a girl's ass in a club? You're not living if you haven't. No, I'm just kidding.
He's okay.
I mean, I'm thinking like a random girl. You're
yes.
Like thinking,
oh, of course. Random. Like,
yeah, it's got to be a random
not
girl.
Not your mother
I mean,
or anything.
I'm with. But,
well, he's still
no,
got
you know
both
what?
His
I know.
Hands.
I just wasn't that kind of guy. I wish I
really
had
like
more
not even when you're like 16.
You know.
Like you're freaking drunk as fuck. You see a girl's ass and just grab
like,
and just walk
me.
Away.
Hey,
yeah.
Toots. I don't know if they'd say
or did you ever do where you grab a dude's ass, your buddies, and you push it forward
oh,
and make it seem like
he's oh, buddy.
Oh, but I'll just grab the dude's ass because I feel comfortable. Like, you know, I mean, it just depends. If I know you, I'm going to, you know.
AP, you're absolutely right. There. He is drinking right now.
Yeah. That's good.
My crew knows me. Again, you guys all know me. Yeah. We have fun. Everything's just about real.
Awesome.
Real good, life, man. Yeah.
Okay. We asked this question with AP. The kinkiest place you had sex at?
So I've had a few... what I think is a decent experiences, but one on the side of a mountain on the busy highway.
Mount Rushmore and shit?
It was at the Dinosaur Point over...
like in the Pee Wee Herman movie?
Big Bertha.
I don't remember what happened in the Pee Wee Herman movie. But no, it was we went down the stairs of the backside of a...
the backside.
The backside.
Yeah. Don't even backside. Ask him his favorite position now.
Yeah, that's the next question. No, it was just right on 152, and you don't know where Dinosaur
on the way
is
to Twainhart?
Like it was like on the way to Los Banos.
Okay, going that way.
Yeah,
that way.
And so
like a tar pit.
Then the rest of the time we're all like on my dad's Cadillac, but I hope he's not
Last Action Hero.
This is some like Area 51 road and shit, man. Like what? That's some freaky shit
That's
there,
some
Paul.
Very kinky stuff, sir.
But he said he had a few, so that was one, right?
Yeah, the other ones were all on, like, cars or in front
Highway
of houses.
And Highway 4 and shit?
Highway 4 traffic.
You say on houses?
No, no.
You say on houses?
Two more hours.
On their doorstep.
Right, they're on Willow Pass. That was Paul.
He's like, fuck it, we'll just throw some drives in here. No one will see us. Come on, man.
Make it like the,
a little
like
ninja vanish.
Like the car is overheating. Putting on some drives.
Yeah. Oh, that's hilarious.
I know you're freaky like that. That's like a double purpose. That's, I know it.
I know. I know. Right, I gotta hide all the real stuff. I'm just giving you all like the PG answers right now.
No. With you. Toast to that. Yeah. Toast.
Cheers.
So with all the guy ass grabbing and the, have you ever had a bromance?
You know, I've never had a bromance. Never
you
could kiss a guy, but I know. No, you know what? It's the
bromance mandate.
I have bros that I can. Just, you know, we could just hang and, you know, be funny and enjoy, not like a bromance, but, yeah, we get crazy.
You get crazy, huh?
Yeah.
Right.
Whatever that
you slipped,
means.
Yeah, you slipped that in. It was like, crazy. We it opened crazy. This Pandora's
He's
box.
Like, shout out to Crazy Bean. I see you later.
Crazy Bean.
Shout out my Crazy Bean.
That's funny.
Sleepovers and shit.
No sleepover. My best friend called me one day out of the blue, and he owns a business in San Francisco, and he says we grew up in the church together, and he says Paul, he's calling me after 10 years of silence.
Yeah.
Paul, I'm like, Ralph, what do you want, man? What are you so excited about? I'm gay. I'm like, all right, and. And he's like, well, so? Did you, yeah, are you right? Are you going to, what? Aren't you going to judge me? Aren't you going to call me and, like, tell me, like, the Bible says that it's a sin and all these things? I said, Ralph, I slept with you before in your own bed, and I would sleep with you again in your own bed. You don't have to worry about me. I love you, bro.
Yeah.
And, I mean, I literally took, you know, he's like, you got to get in the car and you got to come see me. And he's a teacher at Stanford, so I went over to see him, and we just, you know, we
it's
just
very
connect.
Romantic story, right?
That's
there,
the
bro.
Bromance.
Yeah. Maybe Nathan Scott knows him.
So yeah, Ralph knows I love him.
There you go.
Yeah,
awesome.
That's probably a pretty funny phone call to get, though. Just somebody that's super excited to say that they're gay.
Finally,
you know, he just didn't want to be judged.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everybody else he called judged him.
Oh.
Yeah. So
this is like a litmus test, right? You know, we call people up, hey, I'm gay, guess what? And then they're like, you know, fuck you and hang up. Then you're like, all right, don't talk to them no more.
All right, Ralph, you're out.
Right? Paul, you're in.
All right. Which three celebrities would you like to have sex with?
Oh. Well, I was.
Guy or girl?
Oh, girls. And I was like her. What do you mean? Like, what's your face like?
No, because you're touching her.
Well, no, I mean, you know, we think kind of the same, right? I'm not like enamored with celebrities, but I can say after like I've been here and thinking about the, you know, I think I do like Eva Mendes. I like a J-Lo. I think I just.
Oh,
you got
the Latinas.
He likes the booty.
Oh, yeah.
Coco.
You know what?
Iced tea, Coco. Not. Yours?
Yeah, that'd be very upsetting.
That'd be a little bestiality there. But knowing Paul, anything's possible.
If anything is possible. That's right.
So J-Lo,
yeah,
Eva Mendes,
I mean, I'm sure there's so many of them, but I just don't even know all their names. Yeah, I mean, but I definitely have high standards. If they're gonna come in front of me and they're not going to be, I want them to be smart. I don't like women that are just, you know, I don't know.
Spacey.
Yeah. Stupidity is a turn off. You're a sapiosexual.
What's that mean?
It means you're attracted to intelligence.
I am attracted to intelligence. Yeah.
Here, here.
And you just added intelligence into him, Cindy.
Yeah.
Look it up.
I'll trade you for
toast.
But Sam, I didn't have that question as number 10 on mine.
Well, I guess.
Is there 11?
No, it's number 8.
Oh, are we on number 8?
No, but now. I replaced it with 9, but now you're close.
Okay.
Go ahead and close it out. You're reading it sideways, that's why.
That's true. Got the taco neck over here.
In fact, we're all like leaning for you. We're like, can he read?
Have you ever videotaped yourself having sex, sir?
I have never videotaped myself having
what?
Sex.
What?
I know. Why you guys sound so surprised?
I know.
Why is this a shocker?
After all these crazy stories and what you're involved in, you never did anything simple as that?
That sounds.
I mean, it is simple, and that would be awesome.
Has somebody recorded you? She didn't go like, you know what, Paul? I want to take it to the next level. I have this new Canon.
Yeah, put it up there. I would be like, of course, I'd be all for it. I mean, that's I'd be all for
That's cool.
No.
You're like, hold on, let me go shave and real quick and get cleansed.
No, I stay shaved. You can't just go out and like do it last minute.
All right.
You better be prepared.
You just made a visual right now.
Good. Well, don't.
It's stuck.
Good. Yeah. Well. All right. Enjoy.
That's his new chemical. It's the moments that matter. Program.
I know. Huh?
Some dry ice. Yeah, dry ice.
That'll burn right off. Instant hair be gone.
Product. We just made a product. Right there.
Byproduct. That's actually a side thing with dry ice. It does make you hairless. So.
Called the smooth beam.
They don't tell you that. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, you made it through, sir.
Yes, you did. Let's give a big round of applause for Paul on the Vaunted Q&A. Did a great job. Hopefully, 90% was truthful.
It was all true. It was all true.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Let's have a bonus question. Cindy, Shaney, come up with something for Paul. Something outrageous.
Something juicy.
Something really juicy. Something that is crazy.
What's the most awkward or horrible sex story you have that you just had to walk away from?
Had to walk away, or like I was so wasted I just couldn't handle it?
AKA can't get it up.
Yeah, exactly.
No, I mean, like, if you saw, if something.
That's
you know,
the most humiliating one, probably.
No, I mean, somebody that, like, seriously, like, you just. No. If you ever had one of those moments. Yeah, you can quote me on that.
It looked fine, but clothes off.
Uh-uh. No.
Right? A Monet, right?
I'm sure that's had to happen once or twice.
No, I don't. No. I mean,
he says when he commits,
times.
He commits.
Seven girls. Yeah, no, I liked them all.
Oh, serial monogamist. I like that. That's good. That's rare.
And what was the other thing you called them? Sapapo? What was it?
That's a big word.
Sapiosexual.
Sapiosexual.
Sapapo. I did get called metrosexual for the first time in my life, all because of my underwear. How does that happen?
What?
Well, are they like microfiber or like cheeky?
That's it. It's the microfiber.
There you go.
You helped me out tonight.
You know what? I know Paul is sort of drunk right now because throughout this whole time, he's holding the freaking drink with his gloves on.
I'm just throwing off the drink.
It's so cool. I love it.
He's like, it's safe, kids. You got like protective glasses and gloves on here.
These guys aren't safe when you come in the room, but this drink is safe.
You did say come.
This drink
works. Come. When you come. What was that question again?
Okay, so we asked her if she has ever wanted to buy any toys or has any toys. So do you have any toys and have you ever used any toys?
Like, yes. Yes, I have a toy and I use toys.
And would you like to disclose your toys?
The jumping thing.
You know, I think they only make one for guys and they're all like versions of that one. And so
they make one.
Pride? What's that?
That they wear at Pride, those toys.
Oh, I'm going to have to go back to Pride and see what toys they have. But
they make one that you can attach to your tablet now.
What?
That's right. I saw that.
I saw it in the back.
I thought tablet was code word. I was like, what?
No, literally, you're smart.
Yeah, it's basically a pocket pussy on a tablet.
Yeah, you can fuck your iPad if you wanted to.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't think there's only one toy for a guy.
What does the app do?
Never heard of it.
I mean, if you're watching something on your iPad and you have the thing hooked up to it, so you watch and you can fuck your iPad.
It makes like a fap noise like from
that. I hope so. I mean, then what's the point?
It's technology,
right?
Man. All in.
It's crazy.
That's
true. But there actually is this new device, and they're calling it the Guybrator. And it's you can use it alone. Or you can use it while you're having sex with a woman, and you can actually just like leave it on yourself, and it oscillates is how it vibrates, which is different from your standard latex, like replica.
She's like, how do I put it together?
Yeah. But
perfect placement there, Cindy.
Yeah. Yeah, I know, right?
Something your IT comrades could appreciate.
Yeah. No, but Google that. The Guybrator.
The Guybrator.
Yeah, because you can actually use it with somebody else or by yourself.
The crazy shit you learn here on the Slam Show, ladies and gentlemen.
People who spend too much time on it.
This Q&A was brought to you by the Guybrator.
We got to get him as a sponsor. Thank you, Joe Time, for that. Man. All right. Let's go ahead and roll into our shouts and plugs, and we'll work our way down, starting with Mr. Joe Time.
Like always, shout out to Sam. Shout out to Cindy, Shaney. And Miss Sage, always a pleasure being on the show with you guys. Shout out to Mr. Paul and Leah and AP for being amazing guests on the show and just, you know, sharing your talents and amazingness. I actually have a couple shows coming up. You can check it on Facebook. A really big show coming up. Not as big, but Clayton Valley Bowl. If you guys want to see me this Wednesday, I'll be at Clayton Valley Bowl at 8 o'clock. It's in Concord. I'll be at San Jose Improv July 13th. One of my boys, Kabizi, will be filming for his special Comedy Central special, so come out and support live comedy. And I forgot to shout out, yesterday I went to my cousin Jay's baby shower. Shout out to little Jaden, he's on the way, he should be here in a month. And then to all the other babies in our family, like Tristan and my sister's baby, we don't even have a name yet. Hopefully it's Ethan, but you know, something, whatever you want. Leonidas, Maximus, whatever you want to call him. But yeah, shout out to all you guys and everybody watching. Shout out to you guys, appreciate you. Peace.
Thank you, crew. Thank you, guests. Thank you, Little Jays, for fueling this episode.
Yum.
Thank you, Dad, for watching Cocoa Beans. She has a bean name.
That's right.
That's right. Cocoa
that's bean. Always been there.
Right?
She has a bean name.
One down. How many to go?
And shout out to Jeremiah, wherever you are, because I don't know where you are. You left the country a couple weeks. Like a week ago.
Yeah, he's serving us.
And he's overseas. Awesome. Secret stuff.
Thank you.
Secret stuff.
Yeah.
That's so awesome.
All right. So, again, thanks Sam and Joe, Cindy, and Lady Sage. We miss you today. And you guys for coming on the show. It's actually been a very interesting show. a lot of laughs. That's great. And then, of course, all the sponsors. And Planet Beach, Lana's Egg Whites, Natural Life Nutrition, and everybody else watching the show tonight. Thank you.
Cool. Mr. Vogt.
Yeah, I thank you guys too, and thanks for having us here. And so glad to meet you and Lady Sage and everybody at the show. And you know, the newbie's coming on for us today.
You keep touching her.
It's okay.
One of your daughter.
Blame it on the alcohol.
He has gloves on. It's okay.
I guess.
But I want to
look at Sam. He's like, I don't like it.
Yeah, well, she is getting
that's
the rubber glove.
Really smooth.
Oh, good.
Rubber glove.
Okay.
Yeah. I made it. Real
that's actually one of the toys he was talking about.
I made a real.
It's a sex toy. Glove.
I'm sorry. That's rude.
Yeah, but shout out to the Bean team. You know, we're about to go on a long, you know, 3-week tour, basically. By the way, hashtag How Ya Bean, Twitter at, you know, How Ya Bean. You can you'll find us on Instagram, Yelp us out of San Francisco, and it's Facebook, WAC, for all those who know WAC, How Ya Bean. And nobody who knows WAC here, anyway. WAC is a backslash.
That was the same.
And yeah, but to you guys too. Thanks for just having us.
Thank
on
you, sir.
Definitely.
You know, thinking I was drunk.
Did we get our bean names before?
I know. I'm like,
yeah. Did anyone text you?
Did you guys text me?
Yes.
Let's see if anybody texted
that's
me.
That's silly bean.
Silly bean.
Miss AP, your turn.
Yeah. Shout out to you. I know I talked to you like 2 months ago, and we've been planning this since then. Super excited to be here. Thank you so much. And it's great to finally actually meet you. Shout out to your crew. Amazing crew. Mr. Bean and Leah.
Mr. Bean. The Bean King.
The Bean King. Yeah, great show. I really enjoyed myself today. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
And my sister that didn't show up. Bye, Felicia.
Bye.
She didn't come. She like came in.
Lucy.
She said,
"You got some explaining to do."
Lucy Cray, she's not here. Shout out to Cito Crazy, who is on Copycat with me.
Yeah.
Forgot to shout him out.
Oh, that was him?
Yeah, Seat the Crazy.
Yeah, that was sweet.
Yeah, he's pretty dope. He's new and upcoming, too. He has some new songs coming out.
Okay.
He has a really great hit, The Bay. You guys should check it out.
Maybe we could get him on.
Yeah, definitely we'll get him on.
Okay, cool.
He should be with Lucy outside somewhere. I don't know. I'll come find them. Yeah, shout out to everyone who tuned in today, all the followers.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, great show.
And once again, the social media sites where everyone could follow you at?
Annapetta, Instagram, Annapetta, or Facebook, a.p.tangitao.
Cool. And one more time for how you been.
Yeah, hashtag how you been on Instagram, Twitter, how you been, at how you been. Facebook, we're very, very active. I'm very active. You like us, and I'll like you back. In fact, if you don't like us, I still want to like you.
Active and flaring. Awesome. All right, I'll close out the shouts and plugs. I'd like to thank my entire crew. Shaney, Cindy, Joe, and Lady Sage, my girl. She'll be back next week, and we're going to have the greatest comeback return show next week for sure. Lots of good stories that we're going to hear. Our special guests, how you been in the house? Leia, Paul, thank you very much for making the trip out from Tracy, a.k.a. Hammerville. I want to get Hammer on here, man. That'd be kind of cool. Can you go knock on his door and just say, hey? Come on.
Give him a bean name. He'll be here.
There we go. That's all it takes.
That's all it takes, right, Hammer? A bean name?
Hammer Bean.
Yeah, Bean Hammering. Maybe Bean Hammered.
Or Bean Hammering.
Bean Hammered. There you go. That's a play of words. I like it. Perfect. I'd like to thank everyone that's in the chat room interacting with us. You guys are the bomb. And everyone that's watching the show anonymously, continue to creep on every Monday night. That's all we need is for those views to go up. Be sure to like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Yes.
Love us.
All right. That does it for this episode of The Slam Show for myself and everyone here. We'll see you next week.
Peace out.
Oh, yeah. Bad girls in the lobby, let's bring them up. If you're a friend of a friend of a friend, that's good enough. Cause I like naughty girls and party girls. If you came here to drink, don't worry, girl. Enough drink in the minibar, let's fill these cups. Yeah, green light, go, pour one more. Champagne shower on a hotel floor. Take it all off, you don't need no clothes. Bring it up high, baby, drop it down low. And we go, oh, 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 oh. I can't believe this ain't illegal. I just know, oh, oh, oh. It's gonna be one hell of a weekend, baby. Just have a good time. Just have a good time. Yeah, baby. All I wanna do is just have a good time. Just have a good time. We gonna party and do this with you and all your friends.